Hello friends, today we are going to learn about diesel cycle efficiency, and what we are going to derive is 1 minus 1 upon gamma 1 upon r raised to gamma minus 1 rho raised to gamma minus 1 upon rho minus 1 is the air standard diesel cycle efficiency, where gamma is the adiabatic index. It is also equivalent to Cp divided by Cv. R is the compression ratio, V1 by V2, and rho is the cutoff ratio, V3 by V2. Now, before proceed further, let's discuss one thing clearly. Why we are studying such efficiency? In order to correlate how diesel cycle efficiency is behaving with respect to compression ratio and cutoff ratio, this efficiency is derived. So whenever we are learning this efficiency, one thing you need to keep in your mind, that what happens if the compression ratio is increases or decreases, what happens if the cutoff ratio is increases or decreases, that need to be understood in your mind early. And also, what should be the position of the piston while compression process? 1 to 2 is the compression process, means piston moves from the bottom dead center to the top dead center in order to compress the air fuel present inside it. This is diesel cycle, so during the compression process only air is present, there is no presence of fuel. But in case of petrol cycle, air and fuel are present. Okay. Now 2 to 3 process is the combustion process at a constant pressure. In this case, from the injector injecting the diesel droplet, and that comes inside the cylinder, and during the 2 to 3 process it will combust. Means the piston will move for a certain value. Means piston is moving from the top dead center to the two-third or whatever will be the ratio portion. Means some, after some movement of the piston, the whole fuel is combust, means fuel is converted into the gaseous form. And now 3 to 4 process means a piston moves from the particular combustion cutoff place till the bottom dead center, and 4 to 1 is heat rejection process. One thing, my friend, I would like to clear this about is, this is air standard cycle. So while giving the description of it, I'm using that equation, I'm using that the fuel droplets comes inside the engine, but in case of this efficiency, while we are deriving air standard efficiency, there is no fuel present, the only one fuel, and that is air. That's why it is called air standard efficiency. And that is for the general knowledge purpose, nothing else. If you are studying in the engineering, if you are doing masters, then this will be something important to understand. So let's find out the efficiency. Efficiency is given by the equation 1 minus Q2 divided by Q1. Efficiency is equal to output divided by input. Output is work done by the system, and input is Q1. So work done can be written in terms of Q1 minus Q2 divided by Q1. So it is ultimately 1 minus Q2 divided by Q1, and Q2 is given by the equation MCV T4 minus T1, because it is constant volume process. That's why we are using CV over here. And Q1 is given by the equation MCP T3 minus T2. Dividing the numerator and the denominator with respect to MCV, so remaining equation is 1 minus T4 minus T1, because it is divided by the MCV, and denominator will be MCP when it is divided by the MCV. So the remaining part is CP divided by CV, which is nothing but the gamma, adiabatic index, which value is 1.4, and into T3 minus T2. So now what we are going to do, we are going to convert T4, T3 and T2 in terms of T1. Let's talk about the adiabatic process, adiabatic compression process. for the adiabatic process, we are using the equation P2 divided by T1 is equal to P2 divided by V1 raised to gamma minus 1 upon gamma is equal to V1 by V2 raised to gamma minus 1. So here we are going to use the equation P2 by T1 is equal to V1 by V2 raised to gamma minus 1. And we are knowing that V1 by V2 is nothing but compression ratio. So R is equal to gamma minus 1. Sometimes if you have purchased any vehicle, so in the specification of the vehicle, compression ratio is given. Generally, in the petrol cycle, or say if you are using any petrol bike or scooter, the compression ratio is 6 to 8. The range of the compression ratio is 6 to 8. If you are using any diesel car, then the compression ratio is varying from the 14 to 18. So generally, this is the compression ratio. In order to connect it with the manual or specification which we are using in the vehicle, just look it down in order to get a glimpse whether such kind of compression ratio has been used in the practical field or not. So ultimately T2 is equal to R raised to gamma minus 1 into T1. So now T2 is converted in terms of T1. Let's talk about the process 2, 2, 3, which is constant pressure process. Heat addition is taking place. While the process is not adiabatic, it is constant pressure or the constant volume. At that time, we are using the equation P2 V2 divided by T2 is equal to P3 V3 divided by T3. So as the P2 is equal to P3, the equation would be V2 divided by T2 is equal to P3 divided by T3. So ultimately the T3 is equation is V3 by V2 into T2. And T2 is nothing but R raised to gamma minus 1 into T1. And V3 by V2 is nothing but cutoff ratio rho. So T3 is equal to R raised to gamma minus 1 into T1. Now, process number 3 to 4, which is adiabatic expansion process. Again, the adiabatic terms come, and we need to remember or recall the equation T3 by T4 is equal to P3 by V4 raised to gamma minus 1 upon gamma is equal to V4 by V3 raised to gamma minus 1. Here we are taking T4 by T3, so it would be V3 by V4 raised to gamma minus 1. So by dividing the numerator and denominator with respect to V2, if the V3 is divided by V2 and V1 is divided by V2, so V3 by V2 is nothing but cutoff ratio rho, and V1 by V2 is nothing but the compression ratio R. So T4 is equal to rho raised to gamma minus 1 upon R raised to gamma minus 1 into T3, and T3 is nothing but rho R raised to gamma minus 1 into T1. So putting those values, eliminating this R raised to gamma minus 1 from the numerator and denominator, so the equation would be rho raised to gamma minus 1 plus 1 means rho raised to gamma into T1. Putting those values of T4 in this equation of the diesel cycle, instead of T4 putting rho raised to gamma into T1 minus T1 as it is, divided by gamma, instead of T3, rho R raised to gamma minus 1 into T1 minus R raised to gamma minus 1 into T1. Taking T1 common from the numerator and R raised to gamma minus 1 into T1 from the denominator, by eliminating the T1 T1, the equation would be 1 minus 1 upon gamma into 1 upon R raised to gamma minus 1 rho raised to gamma minus 1 divided by rho minus 1. So this is the diesel cycle efficiency, and one can logically comment that what happens if the compression ratio increases. If the cutoff ratio is constant and if the compression ratio is increases, the cycle efficiency increases. If the compression ratio is constant and the cutoff ratio is increases, then the cycle efficiency decreases. So the ultimate solution is putting the minimum cutoff ratio and the maximum compression ratio would increase the cycle efficiency. I hope to see you enjoyed this video. If you are having any doubt, then please ask in the comment. I will try to solve it out as soon as possible. Thank you very much, and your appreciation. Due to your appreciation, my channel is approved now with more than 10,000 views. I would like to thank you all the viewers for such support and effort to make